As a runner, one of the most expensive things you will ever invest in, aside from your running shoes of course, is a waterproof jacket. And we've got to that time of year now where we're starting to think about autumn, winter and perhaps getting rainier. So what better time to start thinking about what you really, really need to have. So here is my guide to choosing the best waterproof jacket for you. So the first thing to think about when you are buying a waterproof jacket, I would suggest, is to think about your budget, because at the end of the day what you want to do is buy the best waterproof jacket that you can afford. And the more you're going to be out in a remote country, the longer you're going to be out for, I would suggest that the more money you need to invest in getting a really good quality one that is going to keep you as dry as possible and as warm as possible in that wet weather. So let's have a look at some of the things that will influence your budget. So first of all, you want to be thinking about the kind of fabric that you want to buy for your waterproof jacket. When you start having a look, you will notice that some of the jackets, like this one for example, come with a breathable fabric that looks, they look something like this. And it's breathable is, I guess, a term that is partly true. You will never get a jacket that is 100% breathable, that will let out all of the sweat that you make, but some jackets will be more breathable than others. So if you're somebody that sweats an awful lot, you might decide to choose one that is a bit more breathable. But at the end of the day, even if your jacket, if you can't afford a breathable jacket, don't worry too much, because it's better to be wet from warm sweat than it is from the cold rain that's got in. Once you've decided between breathable and non-breathable, you want to think about things in terms of fabric, like the colour of fabric. So do you want to be really visible when you're out and about, or do you not? There are lots of arguments saying that if you're going to be running out in wild country, it's better to have something where you can be spotted easily. You might want something where you can be spotted easily if you are running along the roads. And in that case, you might want to look for some reflective features as well on the fabric that you are choosing. You also need to think about how small your jacket will pack down. If, for example, you choose a jacket with a really lightweight fabric like this, you can see you can almost scrunch it up into the ball of your hand and you'll be able to carry it or easily fit it in a pack. Whereas if you choose something with a heavier fabric, it's going to be more difficult. Once you've picked the kind of fabric that you want, a lighter one or a heavier one, a breathable one or a non-breathable one, then have a look at the shape of the jacket and think about how long is the jacket. Some jackets, like this one for example here, have a longer bit at the back that will keep your bottom dry as you're running, okay, whereas others, like this one, will more fit you and cut off at the waist. You need to look at the hood and think about whether you want a hood for your jacket. If you're going to be out running in the rain a lot, you may feel that hood is worth a worthwhile investment. Jackets with a hood tend to cost more than jackets without. If you are going for a hood, then have a look at the features at the top of the hood. Is there some kind of string like this that will actually tighten the hood around your face to keep the rain out? And is there a peak, a little peaked cap like this one, that will help to keep the rain off? Both of those features will help you. If you've got the drawstring without the peak, then that can be a little bit more difficult to keep the rain off your face, but still worthwhile having. You also want to consider how you will actually feel running with your hood up. Personally, I tend not to run with my hood up unless the weather is absolutely vile, because I find that the hood actually pulls my head down, particularly if I'm wearing a pack. However, the jacket here has got an adjustment at the back that will allow me to make that a little more comfortable. Not all jackets will have that, so that's a feature that's worth looking for. But you might decide that actually, for you, you're better off having a jacket like this that's got no hood at all. It's just got a very simple collar with no fastenings or anything on it, but wearing a waterproof cap. So that's something to consider. Okay, you want to also look at the zip on your jacket and make sure that the one that you choose has got a zip that is not going to let the rain in. If you look at this one, you can see that the fabric comes right up to the zip, and the zip's actually got a covering on it that will mean it doesn't leak. If you look at the zip on this one actually has a slight covering that covers it up. So both of those would work really well. Moving across the jacket from the zip, have a look at the cuffs of the zip. The cuffs of the jacket. On the most basic level, your jacket will have an elastic band around the cuffs to keep it fitted snugly to your wrists. You may decide that you actually want something that is more adjustable. So for example, you can get jackets with a Velcro strap like this that will allow you to have the sleeves more open and closed depending on how warm your arms are. So that's an option to look out for as well. Moving down the jacket, pockets. Do you want pockets? If you want pockets on your jacket, think about whether they need to be zipped or not. Generally, again, look, if you're going to be out in really vile weather for a long time, it's better to get jackets that have got a good quality zip in them that will keep your possessions inside dry. And if we just take a quick look inside and see how large the pockets are, this one I can easily fit my hand in. In fact, I can fit quite a lot into that pocket, probably a whole map if I really wanted to. So think about the size of your pockets. But again, if you're somebody that runs with a pack, or you've got pockets in your leggings or shorts, you might prefer to choose something like this that's simply got no pockets at all. Again, that's a matter of personal preference. Final thing to think about is probably one of the most important, which is the inside of your jacket and how the seams inside your jacket are made. So I'm just going to show you here. Okay, inside, if we don't zoom in, you can see there that these seams are taped, and this is a really, really important feature of a good waterproof jacket. If a seam has been taped, it means that water will not seep in from the outside through the seams, and that is why a lot of trail racers and fell racers will specify that you must run in a jacket with taped seams, because it will keep you much drier than a jacket that hasn't got tape seams. If we have a look at the other one here, you can see this jacket, where are we? Let's get the seam showing. The seams in here, okay, are just normal, regular stitching. And so there is plenty of scope there for water to leak through from the outside to the in. So if you can afford it, buy a jacket that has got tape seams. I would really, really highly recommend that. It's much better value for you. So, in a nutshell, those are my top things to think about when choosing a jacket. Have a look around. You can get some great bargains if you don't mind having last year's model, either from your local running shop or from some of the online sites. There's plenty of choice out there, and the final thing to do is find one that actually fits you and is comfortable and works well for you. Okay, thank you.